My name is Drake Smith. We're here in Lily Yong's lab at UCLA. I'm a second year PhD student, and we work on engineering immunity in this lab. Specifically, we genetically engineer the immune system to try and make it better at fighting diseases such as autoimmune disease and cancer. So I grew up in Idaho on a farm. Grew up in Idaho and then moved to Utah to do my undergraduate degree, and then I moved here to UCLA for my PhD. I'm a scientist because I find it interesting. In grade school, really all subjects interested me, but science was the subject that really kind of sparked my interest because you weren't just learning something that somebody else had learned, you were actually discovering something. That's really why I was attracted to research. It's because you're not reading something in a book that someone else figured out. You actually get to figure out something new. When I do research in the lab, I'm the first person in the world to know something, and that's probably the most exciting feeling I've ever had. So we'll go straight in. The first thing you have is the forward and side scatter.
Mm-hmm.
So neither of my parents are scientists. My dad's a farmer and my mom's a CNA. Most of my family have gone into business or medicine, but I think I'm one of the only actual PhD students in heart science and research.
PE6B11, which is INKT.
So as far as my interest in science, I've always really been interested in the science. Probably when I first started watching Bill Nye the Science Guy. I'm definitely one of his acolytes. I remember watching the videos and renting all of them to watch them. And again, it was being able to learn something new and then figuring out how something worked. So I'm actually not very good at math. Calculus 2 was probably the hardest class I ever took in college. I almost failed it. I'm okay at basic math, but it's definitely not one of my strong suits, and that's part of the reason I'm actually in biology, is that it doesn't require as much math as, say, chemistry or physics. I can definitely say to people that as long as you can pass your classes, you'll be fine. So when I first started doing science, I was actually doing very basic science on enzyme research, and this was just a pursuit for knowledge. I moved into this research because I want to do something more translational, something more applicable, and now I work on actual cancer treatment. A lot of people in my family have cancer, but I wouldn't say that's my actual motivation. I'm more motivated, again, for the thirst for knowledge. That's why doing the research before, and very basic research and the research now, I've got the same level of interest. It's just figuring out how things work. So in the lab, I mostly work with culturing cells and doing flow cytometry to analyze these cells. The overall mission of all of this is to come up with a novel immunotherapy treatment for cancer. That's kind of my specific goal in the lab, is to try and come up with a new treatment for cancer, utilizing the body's own immune system. There's been a lot of work already trying to modulate our own immune systems against cancer. There's many, many clinical trials done on this, many successful clinical trials. My treatment focuses on a new type of immune cell that isn't studied as much and hasn't been kind of utilized or seen its full potential yet. So I focus on this cell because we think it could be more of a universal treatment, able to treat multiple cancers instead of having to develop a specific treatment for each kind of cancer. The biggest thrill of my life is that when I do discover something when no one else has ever known that. Again, when I do that experiment and see that result and I know that I'm the first person ever to ever see that and ever know that is a huge thrill. And then being able to present that and show that to other people and teach somebody something, not just that I learned somewhere else, but that I found out and that I'm actually teaching them a new thing. That's my motivation to people.